So, as we all know about the topic, but I think I need to introduce myself. Mera naam hai Heta Shah Ramani, and I am a moderator of this session. Jab mujhe pehle pata chala about the Ahmedabad International Literature Fest, main itni fascinating feel karne lagi ki nahi, isme mujhe part lena hai. So, I called the organizer and said, I want to be a part of this session. And they were like, okay, fine, we'll work out something. And finally, I'm here. And being a literature student, I'm a with English. So being a literature student, I think it is a most fascinating and wo college ke din yaad aa jayenge mujhe. Because English literature, you can understand Shakespeare. Pehle bilkul bhi kitab ka keeda nahi tha mere mein. But first time, meri ma'am ne kaha ke ek kaam karo, शेक्सपियर पढ़ के आओ. एंड आई वॉज लाइक क्या शेक्सपियर पढ़ के आऊँ, मूवी देखने को बोल दो, इट्स ईजी फॉर मी. एंड लेकिन जब पढ़ना शुरू किया, आई कैन रियलाइज कि वर्ड्स में क्या ताकत है. यू नो वर्ड्स जो आप पढ़ते हो, पढ़ते पढ़ते यू फील कि एक पिक्चर चल रहा है आपके सामने. वो पिक्चर में अपने आप को कहीं ना कहीं फिट करना चाहते हो, आप हीरोइन बनना चाहते हो या तो फिर वैम्प, एनीथिंग, बट फिट करना चाहते हो. एंड आई थिंक this is the most beautiful thing. And if I'm talking about romance, ye word mein itna pyar hai ki iske bare mein bolna, aur koi agar book dikh jaye romantic genre par to hum sabse pehle usko prefer karte hain compared to other genre. If I'm talking about myself, to main bhi yahi karti hu. So what you think guys, ki aisa kyun hai, why romantic genre is that much appealing to the mass compared to other genre, why?
I think because we all have some kind of relationships in our life, it's not necessary to have that romantic relationship, but we have friends, we love someone at least, and when you read such kind of things in that book, somewhere we feel ki nahi, ye mere saath hua hai, ya to mere friends ke saath hua hai, or probably I have seen such kind of people around me. And it is very important when you write such kind of genre, and that is the best part about it. And you get recognition only when you will be able to connect with the readers. So once you get that kind of appreciation that yes, I am able to feel whatever you are writing, or I am able to understand what you want to convey, then I think as an author your work is done. And because it's not that easy to portray the emotions and to feel exactly what the other person might be feeling at that time will be very difficult. Because main bhi jab books likhta hoon, whenever it's a process of around 6 to 7 months that it takes, and in that period I actually live the life of the characters. And somewhere when I finish writing that book, I feel bad that now these characters won't be with me. So I can understand what a reader can go through, but then an author goes through it more, because reader reads the book, he can at least switch to the next book and get into their lives. But then an author lives with those characters for more than 6 months, 7 months, or probably more than a year. And that is the best thing, that each character somewhere teaches you something positive about life. That is what I personally feel.
You, what you feel? It's working? Yeah. Okay, I'll pick up from what he says, that he says that when he writes the novel, a romantic novel, he feels the characters, you know. So I think it's a kind of a therapy, it's a kind of escape for a writer as well as for readers. As people, as human beings who are living in such kind of fast times, we all need escape. And where do we find escape? In romance. Now, but for romance for me, it's not just a man-woman relationship. It's very, very wide, you know. It's to do with your relationship with yourself, with nature, with anybody, but a relationship that provides fulfillment. So I think romance is very popular because it provides escape that we all need.
That's true, that's true. What do you feel, Faraaz?
I guess the other two have pretty much captured it with respect to the emotional angle. So what I will add here is the industry angle. What exactly happened in back in 99-2000 was a guy named Chetan Bhagat arrived on the scene, right? And before that, you had Indian writers writing, but these were all literary works. So you had a Rushdie, you had a Arundhati Roy, you know, amongst the popular names. You had a Kiran Desai. So these are all literary, you know, works. And literary works for an audience that is reading the kind of fiction that is coming out today sorry to say, but full of metaphors, right? Full of figuratives, right? So it wasn't really gonna go anywhere with that kind of a TG. So what commercial fiction actually did was ended up opening up a market which already existed, but no one knew that it existed, right? So in our business terms, we call it as a blue ocean, undiscovered. But so Chetan Bhagat did that. And then books started coming out for around, right now obviously publishers can afford that price, but that time it used to be 95 rupees, 95 to 100, right? So, and the entire publishing industry, you had indigenous publishers cropping up left, right and center. Delhi became the publishing capital. There's an area in Delhi, if you go there, Daryaganj, it's littered with publishers. Like literally, people think that it's difficult to publish a book. You go to Daryaganj, you'll have n number of options, right? So suddenly the commercial boom came in. Now, why did that came in? What was this commercial fiction? Ultimately, if you see Chetan Bhagat or any other commercial writers that followed after him, right? Because most were the typical engineers who, you know, had a love story of their own and wanted to basically recount their college engineering days. So those kind of tales typically found a relevance with the audience because the masses could identify with their lives. Oh, you know what? I'm an engineer too. I'm a college going guy too. I loved a girl too and she didn't reciprocate my feelings. You know what? I am the next door guy that I can picture. He's reading this book right now, right? So building that kind of a character who everyone could relate to, right? And this weren't your characters that had typical nuances that you would usually see in something which is akin to a literature work. These were characters that anyone and everyone could identify with, stuck to template. Even stories were templatized, right? Boy meets girl, the parents have a complication and they can't picturize the two together. There is no future, one will part off, and then they realize they can't live without each other and they will come back. Okay, the stories also were templatized. But there was a market for it, right? And publishers wanted writers to write that. So actually, when I started way back in 2010, the book that I had written was pretty different from the one that came out. Because publishers also started having a say in what ultimately should come out. So, okay, this might not work for the market. It's good. It won't work for the market. You should, this is our suggestion. This is what you should go ahead with. So writers also started adapting accordingly. So ultimately, it became a market for the readers. And I believe in any reading economy, right? That's a good thing.
Okay, so I can say ki public ko ek ladka aur ladki pyar kare wo bhi chahiye, mile wo bhi chahiye, bichde wo bhi chahiye, lekin beech mein kuch creative chahiye, right? And I think ye aisi cheez hai jo har insaan ko appeal karti hai, romance. So easy escape in your words. Okay, pehle waisa tha ki ladka ladki pyar mein padte hain, milte hain, bichhadte hain, lekin now the scenario is changed. Sometime सेम सेक्स लोग भी प्यार में पढ़ते हैं और वो एक्सेप्ट किया है हमारे कल्चर ने. सो लिटरेचर में उस हिसाब से कोई चेंजेस आए? इफ आई एम टॉकिंग अबाउट ट्रेडिशनल रोमांटिक लिटरेचर एंड वर्सेस मॉडर्न रोमांटिक लिटरेचर, व्हाट इज़ द डिफरेंस? व्हाट यू गाइस फील?
पहले तो मुझे लगता है कि जो सेम सेक्स लव है, इट इज़ नॉट समथिंग न्यू, इट इज़ वेरी ओल्ड. होमोसेक्सुअलिटी इज़ अ वेरी ओल्ड आइडिया. And we have it in Mahabharata, Ramadan, in Shakuntalam, Abhiyanam Shakuntalam, right? We have connotations to this romance in various traditional texts. But what has happened is that over time, jo traditions hai, wo vary karte hai, trends vary karte hai, toh this became very, it was suppressed in our kind of society. So abhi kya ho raha hai present mein, our Indian community, we are warming up to the idea of homosexuals. So there are publishing houses like Queer Inc. and there are magazines that support LGBT community, right? They support. So there are a lot of anthologies coming up on LGBT community. And like, for example, in fact, it's not just our times. It's like, Lihaf or Kamla Das's My Story. All of these are very bold texts. So they are now more accepting of the people who have another kind of orientation. And this in the kind of orientation is not outside the mainstream. It is one of the mainstream orientation. So we are warming up, sure. into this kind of a thing, and we're accepting these kind of writings. Like, you know, Kazi Ali is a very favorite poet of mine, and he writes very beautiful poetry, gay poetry. So does Hoshang Merchant, you know? So yes, we're warming up.
So I can say ki experiment ho raha hai in literature, and what you guys feel, kis type ka experiment you see?
I have already written a book on it. She Swiped Right Into My Heart was basically about same sex. And it was about the girl's realization that she's a lesbian and about her acceptance. Because hum kitna bhi kuch bhi bole ki, we have LGBT communities, we have NGOs working for them, we have made beautiful ads these days on YouTube regarding them. But then at the end of the day, it comes down ki what and how you will face when you are indoors. To convince an Indian parent is very difficult. I always say this thing. And how will you say? Because suddenly our mindset changes. Or when I was going for the tours of that book also, I said the same thing, that the mindset changes. It's like, yeah, we are very open that yes, we support LGBT group, we support same sex, and it should be allowed, it should not be illegalized and all those things. But then at the end of the day, jab tumhe pata lagega ki your friend is a gay, your friend is a lesbian, your attitude towards that person will change.
True, very true.
And this is something that happens. So now, when this thing happens with friends, when we belong to the same generation, how that person will open up to their parents, to their relatives, and all different kind of relations that we have. So this is one thing that if someone, because at that time also, I met LGBT communities, I met different people at that time, and they were so happy that I wrote about it in commercial fiction. And the best part about it was they were openly talking about it. But somewhere they never wanted their identity to be revealed because they had this fear. And even if we are coming out of that closet, still the basic question still remains the same. How are we going to convince our relatives and our surroundings about this thing? Because the basic idea over here is, and the perception over here is, same sex means if a certain guy is a gay, then uske aaju baaju mein bhi nahi jana chahiye, as if he's infected with some kind of virus.
That's true.
That nahin, ye to matlab wahi cheez sochta hai, yahi cheez karta hai. And the saddest thing about this thing is, we still make jokes on those things. And the person who belongs to that community himself has made a dostana on it. So you see how hypocrite we are on this subject, that when you know that this subject is very sensual and you should handle it with care, you just cannot pass comments, you just cannot make a joke out of it. And it should be treated equally. And at the end of the day, as I said, it comes down to indoors. So the more you write about it, the more you speak about it at such events, through books, through movies, and you handle the subject properly, I think we will be open to it.
And Faraaz?
Okay, so my next one is actually a love story of a transgender, right? So it's one of the most challenging works that I've taken up. And during the research, I did meet a few from those segments. And kind of just trying to understand their lifestyle and their everyday struggles, right? And this is something that they face on a daily basis, basically, whatever he highlighted. And, you know, trying to adapt this into literature, right? That's also a challenge because you never know how the public will lap it up, right? So, to be honest, I haven't started pitching that book yet. So I don't even know how publishers will react to it, right? So it's always a risky territory, attempting anything that hasn't been done or has been done by very few, right? And trying to find a niche within it of your own. Anyway, so addressing it from, an industry perspective, I would not just address romance, but literary work in general that is seeing adapting that you term it as. So there will always be one work that will define, a new segment, a new territory, and then there will be a lot of Me Too concepts. This is how usually the industry works. So back in the West, you had something called a Twilight, right? And even Indian writers started taking it up. So suddenly there is outcropping of vampire fiction everywhere, right? You have Closer Home, you had writers like Varsha Dixit and a few more. So Mayankar, right? So they wrote vampire fiction. Then there were the zombie outbreak. So everyone started writing about zombies. Right, then Amish Tripathi came up with Immortals of Melua. So suddenly people realized there is something called Indian mythology which is other than Ramayana and Mahabharata. Okay, so let us take this up. So this will always be a trend. So experimentation is always about realizing that one particular segment which hasn't been, you know, really broken into. For example, personally, closer to home, it is interesting to note that a lot of Indians actually also read horror, right? So if you see Stephen King, Dean Koontz, you know, they have humongous, tremendous sales here, right? But there is a quality, there is a dearth of Indian horror writers. If you see Indian horror writers, hardly anyone comes to name except for Ruskin Bond, who basically writes horror that is also suitable for children, right? So it's not actually like something like raw horror. Right, that you can compare it with someone like a Stephen King. So when I wrote my second book, The Other Side, which remains India's highest selling horror title so far, I realized that the same insight basically I told you. And I wanted to cater to a market which existed, but I believe that no one was doing justice to it. So this was the same insight I kind of discovered that market. And post that book, there have been, an outgrowth of Indian horror titles coming up, right? So this is always a trend. It's always going to happen. Experimentation.
If I may be allowed to say, but then, do you think this same-sex love, more than a trend, it is about expressing yourself?
Yes, but actually what I feel, Shelly, ki express karna, okay, aap logo ne express kar diya, aap logo ne books likh diya, achhi novels likh diya, poetry likh diya, but jab main wo book khareed ke laati hu, meri shelf pe padi hai, aur koi dekh lega, to kya? Ye question actually hum logo ke liye hai, ki agar kisi achhi novel banti hai same sex pe, main wo leke aati hu, मेरे हॉल के सेंटर टेबल पे वो मैं रख पाऊंगी
हमें वैसे भूल करती थी क्विल के अंदर चुप कर मॉम डैड से
सी
स्किल्स वी यूज्ड टू डू दैट सो हाइड अ बुक एंड
व्हाई शुड एक्चुअली वी ऑल आर यंग वी ऑल नो कि क्या चल रहा है दुनिया में और ठीक है सबकी खुद की चॉइस है वी हैव टू एक्सेप्ट इट एटलीस्ट हम तो एक्सेप्ट करना शुरू करें हमारे पेरेंट्स ठीक है दे हैव देयर ओन अपब्रिंगिंग मैं किसी को ब्लेम नहीं करती बट एटलीस्ट हम तो इतने गट्स रखें कि टेबल पे रख पाए इफ वी डू हमारी नेक्स्ट जनरेशन इजीली हमें आके बोल पाए कि मम्मा आई हैव अ प्रॉब्लम आई कैन से प्रॉब्लम बट मम्मा आई हैव अनदर टाइप ऑफ लव और आपसे ही मैंने ये आपको इसलिए फ्रेंकली बोल पाता हूँ बिकॉज एक बुक देखी थी मैंने आपकी टेबल पर
आई थिंक जहाँ पेरेंट्स की बात है ना बिकॉज आई एम अ मदर ऑफ अ सन तो हालांकि मेरा सिर्फ 5 साल का है लेकिन जहाँ बच्चों की बात है वहाँ पे पेरेंट्स को एज वाइज देखना होता है यू नो बिकॉज इज एन एडल्ट नॉवल विच इज़ नॉट अंडर 18 तो वहाँ पे हमें वो रिस्ट्रिक्शंस रखनी पड़ती हैं बिकॉज इट्स नॉट वेरी गुड फॉर देयर साइकोलॉजी देयर काइंड ऑफ साइकोलॉजी राइट बिकॉज तो वहाँ पेरेंट्स का मानना सही है लेकिन ये है कि हम लोग हमेशा बच्चे ही रहते हैं बड़े नहीं पाते हैं पेरेंट्स की नज़र में वहाँ हमें मुश्किल होती है और जहाँ तक सेम सेक्स लव की बात है सो ट्रेंड यस द ट्रेंड हैज कम दैट नाउ देयर विल बी ट्रेंड इट इज आल्सो अ ट्रेंड बट मोर देन ट्रेंड इट इज expression of a long, long suppressed feelings. And this expression is possible because of media. It's possible because of because the publishing house is also supporting this kind of thing.
That's what I was saying. So basically there will always be one work that will lead it. And then you start saying that, you know, what someone else also has done it. So let me also come out of the closet and, you know, write something
about it. That's just inspiring.
Why should I give that book? I reveal that book to my son and daughter or my accept it.
Am I ready to fight for that book? No, that has been
placed. Yes.
If it is accepted, I don't want to fight that.
See, my question is very simple. अगर मेरे घर में छोटा बच्चा है तो मैं नहीं रखती बिकॉज ऑफ हिज साइकोलॉजी दैट्स ओके बट मैं पढ़ रही हूँ उससे मुझे शेमफुली फील करना
चाहिए
गलत नहीं है इट्स वेरी यंग
कंपैटिबल नहीं है वो गलत नहीं है उसके लिए गलत है मेरे लिए गलत नहीं है उसकी एज के साथ कंपैटिबल
एज के हिसाब से उसको अंडरस्टैंड करना इट्स नॉट या
एंड आई एम मच ओल्डर देन यू आर प्रॉब्ली ओल्डर
embracing parents is more taxative. I'm older than your parents.
Yes.
And I don't have a problem with my son going to go to the
library. And I appreciate it.
More conservative than my generation.
I appreciate
it. So I wish that every Indian parent would have been like you, but that doesn't happen. Because we have this mindset that India means Mumbai, India means Delhi, India means Bangalore, India means Ahmedabad. But then over here we people accept. But then India is much more than this metropolitan cities. And when we go to the interiors, there are still many other problems which never trend on Twitter, but then they still exist. And you cannot deny that.
I'm from Ahmedabad.
That's what I said, that every Indian parent should be like you.
Yes, I'm telling the same thing. I really appreciate your gesture because I'm telling very openly, my parents will not accept it.
See, forget about
because
accepting this
I'm
thing. Exactly. Forget about accepting this thing. My parents never accepted writing full time. So this was the main thing. Exactly. I always said this, I don't go to the family functions because it's very odd. Kya karte kya udhar baat. So that is the thing that goes on, and my parents still think that kabhi na kabhi to ye engineering ka job kar lega.
Yes, yes.
Zakir Hussain was asked, "Aap tabla bajate ho, theek hai, beta karte kya?"
Okay. So I'm very happy publishing house itna support kar rahi hai. I think our society ab bahut change ho rahi hai, wo bhi support karna shuru kar raha hai, jaise main is man ko janti hu, and I really appreciate. Okay, but ek aur question, abhi literature mein bhi thoda farak aa gaya hai. If I'm talking about Twinkle Khanna's My Funny Bones ya Cyrus ki book ki baat karu, to wo jab likhte hain to usme wo expression bhi aata hai, algam, ye sare expression hame dekhne ko milte hain. जब ट्विंकल खन्ना बोलते मैंने ऑटो वाले से बात की एंड ही वाज लाइक उनका मुंह ऐसा हो गया तो आई कैन से इंटरेक्टिव लैंग्वेज ही मिलती है व्हेन आई एम टॉकिंग अबाउट शेक्सपियर और रिदा प्रीतम तो उनकी रिटन लैंग्वेज जो हमें समझना पड़ता है रोमांटिक जॉनर में फराज ये पॉसिबल है कि हम वैसे लिखें जो इंटरेक्टिव भी हो और ब्यूटीफुल भी लगे इज इट पॉसिबल
सी एट द एंड ऑफ द डे राइटिंग इज ऑल अबाउट पुटिंग डाउन योर वर्ड्स दैट यू आर कंफर्टेबल विद राइट if that is a language that you feel comfortable in, then express yourself in those words. It's as simple as that, I believe. So the funda is simple. Write for yourself, edit for the mark.
And what you feel, I feel ki aapke jo books ke naam hai, bahut hi direct hai. Yani aise naam jo kabhi na kabhi life mein feel kiye ho. To mujhe bahut hi fascinating lagta hai ki aise naam hi kyun aap prefer karte ho? Kyun?
Because it connects well with the audience, and once the title is very clear, they know that what's there inside. And yes, you pointed it out rightly that yes, literature is also changing. And when I talk about romance, no matter how embarrassing it is, no matter how awkward it is to accept in the public, but then still, boyfriends call their girlfriends baby, jaanu, and all those things that happens on WhatsApp, and even girlfriends have that pet names that goes into the picture. So when you actually write about those things, I'm not saying to overdo it, but then somewhere in between, if you express those things, there is this sudden connect that happens that yes, this is the thing. And I said it yesterday also in one session that romancing at the riverfront will appeal more than romancing in Paris, which is quite true because we have seen this life, we have our surroundings based in the city. So when nowadays there are Indian icons. If you see the bestseller charts, it's all about Indian writers who have taken over the foreign authors. And the basic reason behind is this is because the way of writing has changed, the language has changed, and somewhere it's about the acceptance that yes, this will change according to the time. I always say this thing that when I'm writing about proposed scene, I just cannot write what was shown in Maine Pyaar Kiya Ki Kabutar Leke Jana Letter, Love Letter. That doesn't happen, but then that worked in that era. But then in this era, it won't work. It's about WhatsApp, it's about social media. So you need to accept about those things and you need to write it accordingly so that it connects well with the audience.
Okay. And
Shelly,
what do you think? Being a woman, male dominance sub bolte, I'm not agree with it. But being a female, aapke apne expression ko, apne lines ke, जैसे आप एक्सप्रेस करते हो, कितना डिफिकल्ट होता है, कितना मजा आता है, क्या होता है?
आपने बहुत ही पर्सनल क्वेश्चन पूछा है, अभी हम और दोनों राइटर्स बैठे हैं तो आई एम श्योर दे कैन रिलेट। देखिए हमारी सोसाइटी में क्या है ना, बंदिशें सारी औरतों के लिए हैं, मेन के लिए नहीं है, थोड़ी बहुत किसी बात नहीं, मेन को ब्रेड अर्न करनी है, चाहे नहीं करना चाहता है लेकिन अर्न करनी है, और वुमेन को ब्रेड बनानी है, पकानी है, पर्दा किसके लिए है, औरत के लिए है ना। तो हमारी सोसाइटी में यू नो वर्जिना वुल्फ ने कहा कि एवरी वुमेन नीड्स टू हैव अ रूम ऑफ हर ओन, यू नो व्हाई, बिकॉज शी नीड्स टू बिल्ड हर ओन स्पेस, शी नीड्स टू बिल्ड हर ओन डिस्कोर्स ऑफ राइटिंग, राइट। वुमेन के लिए इट हैव ऑलवेज बीन वेरी डिफिकल्ट टू एक्सप्रेस हरसेल्फ, एंड शी हैज ऑलवेज यूज्ड वेल एज अ मेटाफर टू एक्सप्रेस हरसेल्फ, यू नो। पोइट्री, आई एम अ पोएट, पोइट्री इज थैंकफुली जॉनरा दैट गिव्स यू वे ऑफ एक्सप्रेसिंग योर सेल्फ थ्रू मेटाफर्स, एंड मेटाफर्स कैन स्पीक मच मोर देन आई कैन स्पीक डायरेक्टली। सो एज़ अ वुमन राइटर, यस डेफिनेटली देयर आर सम चैलेंजेस, आई वांट टू एक्सप्रेस न्यू थिंग्स एंड आई फील दैट द मेल मेंबर्स ऑफ द फैमिली विल नॉट बी एबल टू अप्रिशिएट, विल नॉट बी एबल टू अंडरस्टैंड। फॉर एग्जाम्पल, मेरी बुक में सम पोएम्स हैव रेफरेंस टू फ्रॉइड्स थ्योरी ऑफ पेन पेनिस एनवी, सो वेन दे रीड द वर्ड पेनिस दे लाइक व्हाट आर यू राइटिंग अबाउट, क्या लिख रहे हो तुम, यू नो। But I say these, I'm referring to a theory by Sigmund Freud, you know, these
concepts. Shelly, it doesn't happen like that you do business, male ghar ka business karta hai, ghar mein bhi aata hai, toh unki personal and professional life alag hoti hai, but female, aapki professional life mein poetry likhni, agar usme aapne apni feelings bata di, toh kyun wo personal relate hota hai? पर्सनली उसको रिलेट किया जाता है कि ये क्यों लिख दिया, इट्स योर प्रोफेशनल लाइफ,
क्योंकि जो मेरी फीलिंग्स है वो इट्स अ वेंट आउट टू द सप्रेशन दैट आई गो थ्रू माय डेली लाइफ, यू नो। आई रोट माय पोएट्री बुक बिटवीन द विसल्स ऑफ प्रेशर कुकर, बिटवीन द चेंजेस ऑफ नैपीज ऑफ माय सन, एंड ऑफ कोर्स व्हाट आई राइट व्हाट व्हेन आई एम चेंजिंग द नैपीज और व्हेन आई एम कुकिंग इन द किचन, ऑल दैट आल्सो शेप्स मी एज अ राइटर। आई कैन नॉट जस्ट राइट नॉट अबाउट दैट कम्स इनटू इट, एंड देन इट कम्स इनटू माय राइटिंग एज something, you know, which she's doing against her will. No, I'm not doing it against my will, but I wish I had more time for myself, I wish I had some help, I wish I was not just, you know, in the kitchen all the time. So when I express that, it is a kind of protest. Okay. And this protest is not taken that easily, you know, and in terms of romance, it becomes a bit more difficult. But at the same time, I'll tell you, I'm very fearless, I don't care.
Nowadays it's not the case that ladkiyon ko sirf khana hi banana padta hai, ladkiyan are very smart these days, aajkal wo ladkon se khana bana hi leti hai, aap kuch bhi kar lo, so that happens because I'm recently married, I know this thing and I can say this, and it's not the case that women suppress their feelings and all, the only thing is somewhere there are no women writers in romance who are expressing these days. And if that also comes into the picture, then I'm quite sure that there will be acceptance. But then it's not the case, and it's not that that stereotype has ended somehow. And
that's
I'm quite
true.
Sure the next generation won't follow it.
My hubby is also a good cook.
See, you know, ma'am, when I'm saying that I'm always in the kitchen, I'm not saying that other women are also in the kitchen. But why am I in the kitchen? Because that is the expectation. You know, I'm very happy. My sister is not in the kitchen. My mother is not always in the kitchen. Unfortunately, I am, but I am trying to break that kind of stereotype. I'm trying to carve space for myself because I live out of India. I live in a place where we don't have that kind of support system, and where my husband earns and I do earn, but I don't have that kind of opportunities available in that country, unfortunately. So what I'm doing is I'm trying to create space for myself, and I'm protesting. But what I'm saying doesn't apply to all women. But what applies to me is also because that has been the trend in our society for many, many years. But it's changing, definitely. It's changing.
Okay, so
then your line can have, you can add your line on a Zomato ad, kick the expectations order on Zomato. There are Zomato ads that are going
on. Okay, fine. Humne aapki novels ke bare mein baat ki, aapki poetry mein bare mein baat ki, to we want ki kuch aapke novels ke kuch aise shabd jo hamare audience ko sunne mein mil jaye, even from same your poetry. So starting from you, Faraaz.
Okay, I'm not carrying a copy. Thanks to all the relatives who keep visiting my place. They just take away all the copies that are lying. Okay, so I'm going to be reading a couple of passages from my first book, Truly, Madly, Deeply, as some of you would have heard. Okay, so it basically is a passage that describes beauty from the perspective of the protagonist. Beauty is the only human aspect which cannot be captured on any canvas, however hard an artist tries. At the most, the undaunted artist can replicate the beauty on paper, but what is a replica in comparison to the original? The humbling resemblance can only be respected, not truly adored. Beauty cannot be imprisoned in the lens of a camera. The images of beauty are a moment of its essence. Beauty cannot be displayed to evoke pleasure for all on a cinema screen. Those are just its imprints, mere illusions of its existence. Beauty cannot be described by words. It cannot be written or read about. There are no suitable words in all the languages of the world, ancient or modern, to hold it between a paper and a pen or a script and an eye. Beauty can only be experienced from far, as delightful aroma can only be tasted through one's eyes, and its pleasurable sight can be felt only from the soul. Beauty can only be best described at its origin through a befuddling silence, the kind that leaves one almost on the verge of a pleasurable death just because one chooses beauty over life. There is nothing in this world to hold something so pure, so divine, except a loving heart. And it is the only manner through which love recognizes love. The language of love has no alphabet, no words.
Sudeep.
Okay, so I'm not going to read anything because I find it very boring to read out of your own book. Because I never read, even in my book launches, I never read anything from my book. Because I leave it up to readers. But then I'll just quote one line that will define, and that is my personal favorite. Even if I've written 9 books, the line comes from my first book, and that is still my personal favorite, and it will sum up the entire session of romance. When it comes to romance, we always throw allegations on the other person that he is wrong or whatever it is. You couldn't fulfill my expectations, and all these things that comes into the relationship. So this line was, love can never be wrong, but the person can be. And it covers everything that, yes, you have done your duties, you have been very honest in your relationship, your work is done. But then if the other person is not accepting you as a person and the way you are, then you just cannot change the perception of that person. You cannot change the attitude of that person. But then it's better to move on from there. And at the same time, you should not curse your relationship that I will never like to remember that relationship, wo ek pura void tha mere life ka, and all those things. That should never happen. You should accept it that yes, you loved, you are honest on your part, but then the person was wrong, and that happens. There is no harm in that. You should just move on and accept the other relationship that comes into your life.
Behtareen mood deke usko chhod do, right? Okay. You, Shelly?
So I'll read a poem of mine. It's called Nude Poem 2. Nude Poem 2. This poem, right here, reminds me of another poem. Lost in remembering nothing about itself or the intervention. The scratches here and there uncared into scars recur in amnesic dreams, like the unfinished lines, neither erased nor delivered, squeeze and breathe about in manner of rain-washed earthworms peppered in semi-abandoned diaries. This poem right here about that poem somewhere, a nude poem perhaps that was, one without words for ornaments, one with feelings alone for flesh. A nude poem of yours, a nude one mine. Thank you.
Now, over to you guys if you want to ask any questions, please. Yes, yes, yes.
Yes? No, not now. If you have any question.
इतना लिखा है किसी ने कुछ लिखा हुआ है इंस्पायर कर दो
बट नील का क्या भरोसा कभी भी किसी पे आ जाए भीड़ में उस नजर से देखो आपको समझने वाला शायद यही कहीं मिल जाए आई थिंक देयर इज हंगरीनेस और एम्प्टीनेस पेंटिंग इन द माइंड एंड दे आर जस्ट want something which can feel it from their mind, from their heart. That's why all the books, all the poems, they like to read it. They like to live it. Okay, but very good. Okay, any question? Yes, yes, please.
सर आप लोग जब बुक लिखते हैं मैम आप जब पोएट्री लिखती हैं तो आप लोग है फीमेल और मेल तो जो ऑपोजिट जेंडर होता है उसकी फीलिंग्स आप लोग कैसे बैलेंस कर पाते हैं मतलब हम जब बुक पढ़ते हैं आप लोगों की तो यस जो हमारी एक्चुअली में फीलिंग्स होती है उस टाइम पे सिचुएशन में एकदम मैच करती है सो हाउ डू यू एक्चुअली राइट इट.
सुदीप आपने कहा था कि आप एक एक कैरेक्टर को जीते हो तो वो यही पूछना चाहती है कैसे पॉसिबल है आप फीमेल की फीलिंग्स को कैसे फील कर सकते हो.
सी इट्स नॉट दैट डिफिकल्ट देयर इज दिस माइंडसेट दैट वी मैन आर इमोशनलेस बट देन दैट इज नॉट द केस एंड समवेयर आई पर्सनली फील दैट एज आई सेड दैट आई विजिटेड मैनी एलजीबीटी ग्रुप्स एट दैट टाइम एंड आई एक्चुअली अंडरस्टूड दैट व्हाट दीज पीपल गो थ्रू and what are their tragedies, what are their hurdles and everything. So once I have understood those things, I then try to portray the emotions. I keep myself on that similar position because though there is a thin difference between the thinking, but then I think that is the caliber of that writer. If you can portray the exact emotions what the other gender can also feel at that particular moment in that romance, then I think as a your work is done as a writer. And that's what I said in the beginning itself, that that is why maybe the plot may be similar, the characters may be similar, but then it's about those feelings that you portray through your lines, through your characterization, and the character graph that you give to that particular character is very important.
You have to research and feel. Okay, any
question? I'll just add to that. So he typically answered it with how we connect with that kind of a character. But so I take creative writing workshops all over India. And these are three things that I have realized, are traits or are aspects that every writer needs to capture. So one is definitely, so how does writing happen? So cumulative of all these three things. First is your experience, right? The people you have met, the lifestyle you have led so far, your upbringing, your education, etc. Everything, all packaged under one called experience, right? And every one of us has a different kind of experience in their life. So hence, when we are presented with the same kind of problem, two people are likely to come up with different solutions, right? Second is observation, right? Depends on how actively you are observing, and most writers are very good observers. So like for example myself, even when I'm in a cab, I'm usually looking out of the window. Even if I'm at home, I'm sitting in the balcony, I'm looking at, okay, what's happening outside. So it constantly keeps my mind engaged. And suppose there's a woman standing at the bus stop, okay, why is she looking so glum? What happened? Maybe ghar pe ye, what? And the mind ultimately starts, digging into things, coming up with stories, right? And the third part is the language. It's how you utilize this too and put it across into words, right? And language again is a different person has different types of calibers, right? And even differs in the segment that you are writing. So for example, when a Rajdi says that the guy's heart broke and that day the walls in his house were painted blue, right? He means something else. When a Chetan Bhagat says that, he literally means the walls were painted blue, right? Or a painter came and someone just took up the job and painted it blue. So the language also differs from people to people and the segment you are writing in.
I would also like to answer that question. In my poems, I do have male characters, and I do speak, the narrator is not always a female, the poetic voice is also males. My method is to connect at the level of sentiment. Once I connect at the level of sentiment, for example, I have a poem on a Jallad, and Jallad talks about that he has daughters, and how in her books, Jallad is not only a character, it's also a job. It's a job in primarily, and it's not a word to be phrased like Pathar Dil, in a school book for his daughters. So when I connect at the level of sentiment with the other, who could be a male figure, a mother, a father, a son, or anybody else, then I work outwards from there. That's the first thing. To connect with that sentiment, you have to really imagine that situation. That's my way of portraying other gender or other people in my poems.
Okay, thank you so much, guys. Now, over to you.
Thank you for the wonderful session. I'd like to call on Bhushan Mehta to please come on stage and felicitate the panelists one by one. Shelly Bhoil, Sudeep Nagarkar, Faraaz Kazi, and Heta Shah. Thank you.